What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to be going over how to upload a world onto your 7 Days to Die server. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Playing on your 7 Days to Die server can be a great way to play with friends, but you'll be missing out on your single player world. Luckily, the design of the game and the server allows you to upload an existing save into your server. This is extremely helpful if you want to bring custom or solo worlds into a server so that you can share them with other players. While it is helpful, it can also get pretty confusing. So let's go through the step-by-step process of how to get this done. You'll need to head to the local game directory to find the files first, which can be done by pressing the Windows key and R at the same time. After it opens the Run program, enter %appdata% and then click OK. Find the 7 Days to Die folder and open that up, and then press Saves. After that, find the world that you want to transfer over and then right-click it and compress the folder into a zip file. Once that's done, keep the window open to use again in just a minute. The names of your folder are going to come in handy when you're configuring later, so make sure to keep a note of them. The name of the main folder you zipped is the game world value. For me, it's Apex World. The subfolder's name inside the main one is the game name value. My subfolder would be named My Game. Head to your Apex server panel and stop the server, and then press the FTP file access button in the top left and log in, and then head to the Saves folder. In the top left corner, click Upload on the next page and then drag your zipped world file in to upload. Once that finishes completely, you can head back to the Saves folder in the FTP panel and checkmark the zip file, and then in the top right corner, press Unzip and then click Submit. Once you get a done returned OK message at the bottom of the console, you're all good to go. Head back to the main page of the server panel and near the top left, press Config Files. Find and click on the main 7 Days to Die configuration option, which is also the server config Apex file. Inside of that file, find the game world setting and change the value to match your uploaded save folder's name. After that, a few rows down, find the game name option and edit its value to your uploaded subfolder's name. Once you've made those changes, click Save in the top of the page and restart your server from the server panel. Uploading your existing world into your 7 Days to Die server gives you the chance to share custom or solo worlds with other online players. Although the process is a bit long, it is worth it when you're able to start playing with others on your map. Just remember to keep track of your save folder names so you don't lose your world when you're uploading it. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.